Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you today? I am doing spectacular, and thanks for taking in this next installment of my vlog, Growing Your YouTube Channel to 100,000 Subscribers. Our topic today is I want to talk to you about calls to action, using annotations within the videos to create calls to action, the sort of things that we can reach out to our audience and ask them to engage in within our videos. But before I get to the main topic, I just want to give you a bit of an update on what's been going on here. Technically speaking, you can see we've got the green screen in behind me, and I'm going to give you a long shot showing the green screen kind of all in its mess. It's still not really quite set up, and it's not very well lit yet, but I'm getting there. I'm starting to figure out the whole process of the green screen. Not sure I'm going to love the end result. Having a disembodied head floating in the video screen doesn't really work for me. There are some effects that I have liked. You've probably seen in some of the videos, I stuck my head on top of this big block of ads that I created thinking that was a brilliant concept. Looked like crap as far as I'm concerned. We're not going to go with that. Maybe it's the graphics. I don't know. Maybe it's the graphics in the block and a graphic artist could maybe make it look better. I might explore that option, but overall, my own efforts at making it work were somewhat less than okay. But the big news for the week for us wasn't technical and green screen at all, but it was the launch last week of our campaign on Patreon. And for those of you who are just tuning in to this week's show and haven't noticed it and don't know what we've done, we are embarking upon the crowdfunding model for the Dotto Tech channel. Rather than going out and getting corporate sponsors to help pay for the channel as it grows, I've decided to reach out and ask the audience to contribute a small amount to help us grow and to help support the channel. And Patreon is a really cool option for doing that. I gotta say, I was really thrilled with the response of the audience. Our first couple of days out, that we've got 82 patrons signing up, mainly from the newsletter, from our email list, to the tune of about $178 per month. Now, that was our first blush, because I actually sent out an email asking people to come and support us. So that reached pretty much my whole audience. And I had a really good open rate. When I looked at my newsletter list, email list, they were opening at almost a 50% clip. So about half of the 9,000 people or so on my email list got the request from me for funding. I predicted a fairly large unsubscribe, and there was probably the biggest single day unsubscribe that I've ever had, but not huge. It wasn't huge. So, I mean, some people went, I don't want you asking me for money, Dotto. I'm going to unsubscribe. And about 80, ironically, about 80, 82 to 85 people unsubscribed from my mail lists. And 82 people said, yeah, I'll do it. So it was a 50-50 split. You know which group I like better, personally. I like the 82 that said yes. The 82 that left, that's fine, too. I certainly appreciate the fact that 82 people... You know, as a content provider, it's kind of profound that audience members are willing to take out their credit card and go through that whole process to say, yeah, I believe in your product and I'm going to support you and I want you to continue being able to produce this type of content that I'm learning from. It gave me a pretty good feel-good day for a couple of days there as I saw the first rush of patrons come in and sign up. Where is this going to go? How is it going to ultimately become a real major part of the income supporting Dotto Tech and allow us to do some of the things that we want to do? We will see. But so far, we are looking pretty good on that front. Let's get now back and let's talk about engagement and calls to action within our YouTube channel, within our YouTube videos. Now, you know, I have shown you in the past where we use annotations to create engagement with the audience and to do things like to ask them to subscribe to our website. But there's a lot, or subscribe to our channel. But there's a lot of things that you can use calls to action for within your videos, depending on what your business model is. And we're each going to have different needs. Some of us might have needs to raise money, like I would. Others might want to be growing your newsletter list. Others may be looking for leads. Others might be looking for... There's a wide variety of things that you could be looking to create audience engagement in. But for the most part, it's going to start with your annotations. But your annotations are limited. Let me just go into a video here. Let's just go into the one that we just posted. We'll put this one in. Because this one's got the ugly block. My ugly block, ads. So, Kitchen. I just saw a typo. Isn't that funny? Way to go, Steve. I'm going to correct my typo. Kitchen, Apple. I'm going to save those changes. Me and typos. I actually have a semi-legitimate reason for them. Spell check doesn't always catch, obviously. But I actually have an eye issue. I have the beginning of macular degeneration. I'll come out and I'll tell you. I'll come out of the closet. I'm very young to have it. And it's not very serious. But there's certain times that letters overlap, especially when I'm a little bit tired, where letters overlap and your brain fools you. I actually see what I think I'm seeing as opposed to what's really there. And so consequently, I do more typos than the average. It has nothing to do with the fact that I'm a lousy speller. Really. It doesn't have very much to do with that fact. But there it is. We fixed it as a team. Thanks for helping. Okay, so let's go in and let's take a look at the annotations that I have, which create the calls to action in this particular video. So I've gone in, and this was my grand attempt at a new structure for kind of dealing with the green screen. So there's the screen that I thought might work well, which is this big block of Blocko ads right here. With my head perched like a canary on the top. And thank you to all the people that wrote in and said, Steve, it looks stupid. Because obviously I didn't recognize that fact. Although looking at it right now, I'm somewhat embarrassed by the fact that I did that. At any rate, each of these now is a link that allows a call to action of some sort. So I do it by putting a graphic in saying, please support us or please subscribe to our channel. Now, in the past, I would pop these in at different times within the video, but I thought I would leave them up and create persistence within this ad. I actually haven't noticed it engaging the audience that much more. Maybe it's because they're laughing at me so hard for spelling kitchen wrong. I don't know. Now, I have here three different types of calls to action within this one video. I have a link back to my website, so just visit me back for more information on whatever it is I'm talking about. My call to action as far as supporting us on Patreon, so this is a request for support and funding, and a request for you to subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is the call to action that I've used the longest and the most. Now, there are two different places that you can send calls to action. You can send it within YouTube, so you can put a link to another video, or like this one here, which is an invitation for people to subscribe. And because I have my YouTube partnership, I've reached a level of trust within YouTube that I can create what's called an associated website. So you see right there, it says associated website. That means that I'll actually take you and show you where that is. This is a big step as you're moving along in your YouTube career. You go into, I'm going to the wrong place. YouTube settings. I want to go into my YouTube, I want to go back to just my video manager. I know what I'm doing.
I've got it.
Go back to my video manager. And there in your channel settings, this gives you a status update of where you stand with YouTube in a variety of different areas. And you always have to be in good standing in all of these areas in order to get extra privileges. One of the privileges that you will at one point be able to ask for is this one here, which is called external annotations. And it says, lets you link annotations to external sites or merchant partners. Now, I haven't done any merchant partners. I haven't figured out what merchant partners I can link to. But if you go through this description here, it will allow you to create the opportunity to type in your URL or any page that's pointing to your domain and then send your visitors to that page. And that is a huge step forward in audience engagement because you can do calls to action to your website. So you can invite people to come to sign up for a newsletter or to view the rest of your blog or to a variety of things. You can send people to your site to do. Now, let me show you and prove to you at least my belief that annotations work. Let me go back into my channel. So let's just go back here. And let's go into my video manager and let's take a look at our analytics. If I go into analytics, you have to, as you start growing your channel, you have to constantly pay attention to what's happening in your analytics because it tells you everything that your audience is doing. It tells you where you're performing well, where you're performing poorly, and more importantly, it allows you to compare what happened last week or last month to what's happened this month as you start to change and as you modify and morph it. There is no game plan for being a YouTube content publisher. We're making this stuff up as we go along. So having even a week's of historical data is very useful. But let me show you just how important calls to action and annotations are as far as overall growth of your channel. Here's my most popular video as it's currently running right now. It's my five favorite Evernote features. And it's closing in on about 100,000 views total overall. But in the last 30 days, so these numbers here are just from the last 30 days, from the last month. The performance is it's had 21,000 views. No big deal there. I mean, these are all nice things. This is the thing that makes me sit up and take notice. It's 370 subscribers. This is, if I click on this, I'll get more details, but this is how many people have subscribed to my channel while they're watching this video or from this video. Their action was to subscribe. Now, they might have chosen to subscribe anyways because it is such an awesome video, but also 30 seconds into that video, as for all of my videos, I ask people to subscribe. So before I did that ridiculous block, which I did through the whole show, now we're going to go back to asking them 30 seconds in. But I do that religiously. 30 seconds in, please subscribe to my channel. Or think about subscribing to Steve. Or something like that with that little graphic that I embed in the video. And then I put the call, and then I put the annotation above. And so this is over the last 30 days, what this video has meant to my total number of subscribers every single day. You see the numbers? 13, 15, 10. A total over the last 30 days of 370 new subscribers have subscribed to my channel because of this one video. So if we take a look at my numbers here, if we go back to our dashboard and we take a look at where we are sitting, that's 370 people. I would be today, if I didn't have a call to action in that video, I would be 300 less. I'd be at 22,400. And I got to tell you, it feels a lot better. I'd even be less, 22,300. Feels a lot better being at 22,700 than it does those poor losers back at 22,300. So I think this is proof that the calls to action work. And if you don't believe it, put a video up with a call to action, put a video up that's similar in content, and don't put a call to action. And then take a look at your analytics and decide for yourself. Now, before I leave this topic, I want to take a look again at one of my videos. Let's just bring up the same one as we were looking at. And I want to talk to you a little bit about the privilege. I guess we can call it the privilege that YouTube is giving us by allowing us to link back to our website. Because I don't believe YouTube takes that permission lightly. So they very clearly spell out what we can do and what we can't do with the link back, with the link back to our associated website. And if I think there's always a temptation to try and skirt around it. So for example, the things that we can do very easily, we've already said, get people to subscribe, get people to visit our site, bring them to a page that allow them to subscribe to a newsletter. All those are good. But there are more direct ways that we could create annotations and links back that could create more revenue. I'm doing one by asking you to subscribe to my Patreon page, but that's not going straight to my Patreon page. That's going to an intermediary page where I ask you to click on it to go to the Patreon page. Because this whole thing is set up to send people back to your website or to send you to merchant sites that YouTube approves of. So there might be a temptation for those of you who know a little bit more about HTML coding and know a little bit more about websites to do a redirect of some sort. I have a tool in my WordPress account called PrettyLink, and it's an awesome tool. It allows me to take the long, it's like Bitly, it's like a URL shortener, except it's a URL customizer. So I might take a long link within my own website. I'll just go to Dotto Tech and I'll show you. So I might take a link like to this video here. As a matter of fact, I've done it for this video here. So this is my latest podcast. And you see the URL here, it's dottotech.dt-149-maffin-mason-head-camp. So that's the URL. And that would be a hard one to communicate to people. Because it's for my podcast and my radio show, I do a shortening thing using the Pretty Link. So I just call it dottotech.com/ 149. A lot easier to remember. And watch, what'll happen is it will load. Well, you won't see it change, but it loads. Do you see how it changed in the omnibar there? It changed it to that URL. So I can actually create links to outside websites doing the same thing. So theoretically, you could try and fool YouTube and put your URL pointing to an external website, but using the redirect that you've got by using a tool like PrettyLink. But I think they're going to catch you doing that. I'm not positive because I haven't tried it, but I know that you run the risk of being penalized. And what might that penalty look like? I'm not willing to find out. See, YouTube is too important to my business moving forward. I've committed to publishing full-time on YouTube, being a YouTube publisher. I'm not going to try anything that puts that at risk, including something that might make me a little money. And how might it make you money? Well, let's say it was an Amazon link that you were going to, like an affiliate link, and you've got you're reviewing a camera in your video, and you create a link through to the Amazon merchant account that allows you to get a commission or an affiliate fee based on that camera sale. See, don't do that. Don't embed that in your video. Now, having said that, you can include those, but there's a place and a time for everything. And the place that you would include those links, affiliate links to products like that, is you can put them right here in the description field. You can add links to outside websites, whatever you want, right within here. So you say, please visit my affiliate link, or here's a place to look at the camera that's talked about in this. And you can say in the video, look in the description field below for a link to this. You could do things that way. So that's a way that you can that's a completely legitimate way to create some traffic for affiliate revenue or for anything else, driving people to websites, either your website or outside websites. And before you even get the permission to do the associated websites, that's a way to get people to go visit your site. I hope that all made sense. Bottom line is, if you're building a business on YouTube, if you're building an audience, creating audience engagement is often going to be important. And there's a variety of different ways that you can create that engagement using the different tools that are available to us, primarily through annotations, but just through creative thought about how we can create some sort of traction with our audience. And YouTube, as far as I'm concerned, just a spectacular way to create that traction. I hope you found today's video to be interesting and useful, and a little bit oversharing on my part. I shared an awful lot that I wasn't actually planning on doing at the beginning of the video. Well, that's why I kind of like doing these things as a vlog like this. It allows me to kind of cover off a whole variety of content, and I hope that you learn a lot from this. We're well on our way to our 100,000 subscribers. If I give you an update, I'm not positive that we're going to make our 100,000. I've got to figure out some ways to start increasing that number of subscribers. We're not doing bad. We're not doing bad. We're getting lots of views. We're getting between 150 and 160,000 views per month, which is, I think, a pretty rich, a reasonable number of views. We're growing by 35, 36. Sometimes it says 4,000, but we're growing by over 3,500 new subscribers a month. But do the math. That's not going to get us to our 100,000 subscribers by the end of the year. I'm hoping that staying the course, these numbers are going to continue to increase. They've been flat for about a month. So I'm a little bit concerned for my numbers as far as that's concerned. But remember, I've just titled this series, Growing Your YouTube Channel to 100,000 Subscribers. It's really about building a business on YouTube. And every time that subscriber number increases by one, that's a new person that I now have in my community that I get to form a relationship with. So I feel that I'm getting success every single day that goes by and in this journey of becoming a YouTube content publisher. And with that, I'm gonna leave it off now. It's been a long video. I'm going to finish up with a pitch for you to consider sponsoring us and becoming one of our Patreon supporters. There's lots of perks if you are a supporter, so please click on the link. I'm not too sure I'm going to put it because I haven't figured out what I'm doing graphically with this thing until after I've shot it. But click on the link that you're going to find somewhere here. Go to Patreon, have a look at it, and then decide whether or not you feel that you can become our next supporter. And if you do, good on you. And if you don't, that's okay. Maybe next time. I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.